going on YouTube? Welcome back to Soul Vice. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Air Jordan 6 DMP. Obviously, this is the 2020 version. I'm going to be giving you an in-depth review, so I'm going to give you all the details and let you know exactly what I think about them. And as always, I'm going to be giving you a 4K on-feet look as well. Now, some of you may be wondering what DMP stands for. It actually stands for Defining Moments Pack. So back 14 years ago in 2006 when these originally released, not only did you get these Air Jordan 6s, but you also got a pair of Air Jordan 11s. So they call it the Defining Moments Pack because it was to pay tribute to two of Michael Jordan's championships, the first one being the 1991 championship with the Air Jordan 6 when they originally released, and then the 1996 championship as well when he played in the Air Jordan 11s. Now the colorways were similar. Obviously you have these, which is basically the infrared 6s, but instead of infrared hits, you have gold, and then the Air Jordan 11s were basically Concords, but with gold accents instead. So unfortunately in 2020, there's no P in the DMP, there's no pack, it's just the Air Jordan 6. I think it would have been great to see both of them release again. I don't really know why they didn't release the 11s with the 6s. Maybe it's because of pricing. I want to say that pack back in 2006 was like $300, $295, somewhere in that neighborhood. This pair by itself is $200. So I'm not too sure, maybe that played into it. It would really be cool to see that DMP 11 release as well at some point. But for now, we do have the 6s, and if I'm being honest, if I had to pick between the two, probably the unpopular opinion, but I'd actually go with the 6s. I'm a big fan of 6s. I was born in 1991, so there's that kind of tie-in. And the infrared 6s are just actually some of my favorite shoes of all time. So getting a gold pair is actually not a bad thing either. So I'm a big fan of the DMP 6. So with that little bit of history out of the way, let's go ahead and get into the review. I'm gonna let you guys know exactly what I think about them. Now, anytime that there's packaging that's special or I think is worth mentioning, I'm gonna do exactly that. And so with this pair, you get this black and gold box, obviously to tie in with the black and gold colorway of the sneaker itself. And this isn't the first time that we've seen this style box. It's a clamshell style box, but it's got this kind of two-tone look. So we saw this recently with the Air Jordan 3, the red cements. It was, I think, a black and red color box. But it's kind of like a dip box, almost like they took a black box and dipped it in gold. I think it's a pretty cool look, but I think it's pretty cool that they gave us something special a little bit out of the ordinary just to kind of signify a special release, because in my opinion, the DMP 6 is just that. Now on the inside of the box, the only other thing I think worth mentioning is the paper that you have here. So it's white paper, and then you get this Unite print all over it with the Jumpman logo as the eye. It's kind of hard to see, so I'm not going to bother showing you on camera because it probably won't show up. But just know that that's there. Other than that, pretty much nothing else to mention. Now the colorway on these, official colorway, is black, metallic gold, and black. That's literally the only colors that are anywhere on the sneaker. And then you do have a US retail price of $200. All right, so moving on to the sneaker itself, the upper here is made up of Durabuck or Nubuck. This is a synthetic material, so don't go expecting any super high quality Nubuck or anything like that. Even with that being said, I don't mind this material. It seems to be pretty durable. I have the pair of Air Jordan 6 infrareds that came out last year, and I've worn that quite a few times, and they seem to look pretty good still. So I don't really have any complaints with the material, other than it does collect dust really, really badly. So anytime I want to break those out, I got to hit them with a brush really quick just to dust them off. Otherwise, they're looking pretty pretty dusty. So that's the one thing I'll say. Other than that, I don't mind the Durabuck. All right, so now I'm going to go over the details that make these the DMP 6. And the first thing, the most standout thing in my opinion, is going to be the dog tag. So you get this really cool gold dog tag. Now, I was curious, just because I don't have the original pair from 06, whether or not this was going to be a metal dog tag. Unfortunately, Jordan Brand does like to skimp on material every once in a while, so they'll make something look metal just by painting it a metallic color. But this is actually a metal dog tag, which I appreciate. Now, on one side of the dog tag, it's just got a Jumpman, and on the other side, it reads Air Jordan 6, June 12, 1991, defining moment, MJ's first professional championship. And again, that is what this shoe is here to commemorate. All right, a few other details. Over here on this lace cover, this is that neoprene lace cover on every Air Jordan 6. You've got a gold Jumpman. You've got a gold Jumpman up here on the lace lock. And then you've got a metallic gold hit on the spoiler on the back. I really like this a lot. I'm glad this isn't like a matte gold like they did kind of everywhere else on the shoe. Just gives it kind of a nice pop. And you've got a gold 23 under your Jumpman here on the heel. And then of course on the midsole, you got a couple of gold hits on either side. And then you do have a gold Jumpman here on the outsole. Now the outsole here, one of my all-time favorite Air Jordan outsoles, if not my favorite. It's just super bold with this zigzag kind of pattern and this gigantic Jumpman. I'm a huge fan. So outsole here, kind of business as usual for Air Jordan 6. You've got the icy blue midsole. A lot of people don't like that they're kind of icy blue. I don't mind it so much. I think that it kind of is gonna help with the yellowing over time. The other pair, since it was more of like a clear color, they turn yellow pretty quickly. And then the last thing making these a DMP 6 is gonna be on the insole. You've got a gold Jumpman. And on these, it's a Jumpman that says 2020 underneath in gold. I wanna say on the 06 pair, it was just a Jumpman and then it said Air underneath. But this is a 2020 pair, so you've got a Jumpman and 2020. Now, unfortunately, I do have a couple of complaints with these, and the first one is gonna be the lack of 3M. So on pretty much every other pair of Air Jordan 6s, you've got 3M under the perforations here behind the nubuck. So on my infrared 6s and even on my Travis Scott 6s, you've got that 3M under there that gives it a nice pop when the light hits it. Now, it's not necessarily missing, and what I mean by that is I don't think that there was 3M on the 06 pair either. And I'm not sure if they just weren't doing 3M on the Air Jordan 6s at that time, or if maybe they thought the 3M was gonna kind of clash with the gold. I'm not too sure, but anytime that 3M is taken away from me, especially when it's supposed to be there, that's gonna be something I'm not a fan of. And then the second complaint I have is just kind of like the overall craftsmanship, at least on my pair, the paint job is just not very good. So you've got some black that kind of bled over onto the icy blue outsole there. And then on the other shoe, on the right shoe of my pair, the black paint right here is either faded away or they just didn't hit it enough. And it's pretty much just black right there where it's supposed to be gold. So that's kind of a bummer. Oh, and then on the back here on the spoiler, this gold right here is already rubbing off. So I don't know if it maybe got scratched or if that's just kind of like a sign on how well that gold's going to hold up over time. But I don't know. I think for $200, I would appreciate a little bit more attention to detail on these. Now, as far as sizing on these goes, I would go with just whatever you usually buy Air Jordan 6s in. Now, if you haven't had a pair of 6s before, I go true to size and they fit just fine. I've got a couple of pairs behind me, the infrared 6s and the Travis Scott 6s. And then these as well, I bought them all true to size and they all seem to fit okay. Now, unfortunately, comfort is probably one of the low points for Air Jordan 6s in my opinion. Not the most comfortable Jordans. They're pretty heavy and a little bit stiff. So I would just kind of keep that in mind. I'm not expecting them, and I hope you're not expecting these to be super comfortable. This is a pair of 1991 Air Jordans, so obviously cushioning technology was not all the rage back then. But just keep that in mind, not the most comfortable pair of Jordans, but they feel just like every other pair of Air Jordan 6s I've tried. So overall, I really, really like these. I think they're super sick. The DMP 6s are one of my favorite colorways of the 6s, especially non-OG colorways. I really, really like these. As far as whether or not I'm keeping them, I'm super, super torn because I absolutely have to have those fire red 5s that are coming out at the beginning of May. And because of the coronavirus situation, again, I'm being super selective with what I bring into the collection. So I'm kind of either between these or those. I kind of don't want to let either one of them go. I'm thinking about maybe selling my Black Cat 4s. I don't really know. Somehow, some way though, I do have to get those fire red 5s. But these I'm thinking about keeping as well. So I'm a big fan of these. If you're thinking about copying them, I would just not even think about it any longer. Just pull the trigger. You will not regret it. These are super sick. They did a really good job of keeping these close to the 2006 pair from what I hear. But overall, this is a really nice Air Jordan 6. Black and gold colorway. Can't really go wrong there. And it's commemorating his first championship. Michael Jordan's first championship, that is. So yeah, there's a lot of story to these. Great colorway. Definitely a cop for me. Now, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, that way you're notified when I post new videos just like this one. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up if you're a fan of Air Jordan 6s, and then in the comments, maybe you can help me settle my dilemma. Three pairs of shoes, one has to go. So you've got the upcoming Air Jordan 5 Fire Red, you've got these, the Air Jordan 6 DMP, and then the Black Cat 4s that came out a few months ago. I'm getting rid of one of those, so let me know which ones you would get rid of, and let me know which two you'd keep. All right, other than that, guys, I will catch you in the next video. Later.